What's up, guys and gals? It's me, your old buddy Mr. Moose, back with another edition of Transport Fever. This is episode 16 of our free play series. We're working on a US theme map, and today we are going to do a little something about our transport situation. We got to move some more goods because we are starting to get backed up a little bit. Things are going well though for us, and we are up to 1970. I did go ahead and go forward a couple of years working on spacing out my trains a little bit to get them right on the pasture line so that we could get some sort of even spacing. I've got some of it worked out. I think I'm okay, but I got a big, huge gap up in this area right now that we're going to work on a little bit later on. But first things first, we've got a new vehicle. In 1970, we get the Peterbilt 359, capable of moving 19 materials, and it does everything. So this whole situation we've had with the Studebakers, they get to go bye-bye, and everything gets to be replaced with the Peterbilt 359, which is able to do a top speed of 50 miles an hour. It can hold 19 materials, and as I said, it's universal and can haul everything for us. So that's good stuff. So we'll start here, down here where we've got all this stuff backed up in Thousand Oaks, and we will start replacing some vehicles. So let's get going on that. By the way, just to look at our ledger real quick, our airplanes are making a little bit of money, not much. Our shipping has definitely improved with the addition of two cargo ships on there. I think that is definitely going to work out for us. And then our train is up to $15.3 million. Now, remember, the goal was to beat 13, 14. So we have already beat our goal with $15.3 million. So that is good stuff there. So we're in good shape with that. So I'm pretty happy so far. All right, so freight truck replacements. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to sell everybody, and we are going to just buy new trucks. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's go ahead and return everything on this line, sell it. Everything on this line, return it and sell it. Then come over here and buy road vehicles, buy one, two, three, and put those on freight one. Set the line for Thousand Oaks freight one. There we go. And do the same thing again, one, two, three. And set that line for Thousand Oaks freight two. Done. All right, so now we've got the Peterbilts rolling out, going through town, looking good. Check them out. That's a good looking truck there. All right, so we'll have those now moving through town. They'll do their thing, and that should eliminate some of this backlog that we have here. Though we could stand to do some road upgrades to take advantage of that 50 mile an hour speed that they can do. Those are 31, these are 43s. Let's see what we can upgrade to 43. Let's see what we can do to 43s. Magic wand, 43s. We get to go to our six lane to get bigger, but we should be able to do that and that. That. All right, so where does this route go? Let's look at our route real quick. Make sure we know where this road's headed to. Let's pick up Thousand Oaks. Is it two that goes, or is it one that goes? I think they both go pretty much everywhere. All right, so we come out, we go up here, and we go, oh, we can't do it. Come on. That's a bum deal. How about here? Oh yeah, we can upgrade that. We can upgrade that. We can definitely upgrade that. We can upgrade that. We're not getting the maximum speed out of these guys, but as long as we get more speed out of them, That's what's going to be important. So we'll upgrade as much of this road to there as possible. Why can't I get that whole road construction upgraded? Oh, too much slope, too much slope foot. All right, well, most of that road's going to be upgraded. All right, and then we want to get this road here coming down the hill upgraded so that we can get as much speed out of these guys as possible. I mean, I really don't care about the rest of the city. I just care about where my trucks are driving. So let's get them as much speedo as possible. Yeah, I know. Some of these roads, some of these businesses have got to go away in the name of progress. They'll come back. They will come back. All right, so just alone, those trucks are going to haul more materials, but with the increase of speed, that will be good too as well. So we'll get them going in there. It's funny to watch them come in because they come around and then the back of the thing just snaps into place. So funny. Let's watch the next one come in. Cracks me up. All right, so in the truck comes, goes in, does this little thing, and then the back goes into place. That is so funny. Does it on both sides too. This truck over here will do the exact same thing. There we go. And we're in place. That's some pro backend right there, or pro parking right there. We should take tips from that. All right, anyway, so that much is done. Next thing we need to do is do the same thing for all of the areas up here. So let's go up here and let's get rid of some vehicles up in this area. So this is Oklahoma City. Let's come up here. All right, so Oklahoma City, freight two, get yourself. Let's just replace freight two because I want three trucks on there. So let's just go in there and say set vehicle. Yep. And replace those. Yep. And then over here, Oklahoma City freight one. Yeah, I don't need that many delivery trucks. I think we've been losing money because we've got too many delivery trucks. So we'll come over here to freight and we'll buy. And we'll get, what do you say we get four? One, two, three, four of those. Set those on the line. And those go to, freight one. Yeah, freight one, Oklahoma City freight one. That's what we're putting them on. I hope I did that right. Yep, freight one, good. All right, so those trucks are out on the on the run. And they should be doing pretty good. Irving only has like four trucks total going right now and probably needs some more, maybe, kind of, sort of, I don't know, maybe not. Let's see, why is that one truck not gotten done? Irving freight one, let's replace these vehicles real quick. Oh, not like that. Say no. Set vehicle to that. Now say yes. Well, I almost messed that up. I might have messed that up. I hope I didn't mess that up. All right, so that's that one. And then we'll come over to this one here. All right, truck's coming in and he didn't replace because I don't think that's the right line. Irving freight two. Give me that one. Replacement. Oh, come on. Cooperate with me. Realize that I'm slow and you're fast, computer, and just work with me here, okay? There we go. There we go. And we should get all that replaced. waiting for that Oklahoma City Road Depot to fill up. All right, boys, come on, drive around, get yourself replaced. Oh, there we go, there's one. Nice. There's one. Come on, I need two more. Oh, we messed up our routing, didn't we? Uh-oh, I gotta look at that. When I took out that little bit of road right there, I messed up the routing for that, for those deliveries. Now they're having to go all the way around town. Huh. It's not terrible. That'd be fine. All right, there's another one upgraded. Let's see. All right, all of them are upgraded. Thank you. Oh, got something new coming in. Oh, yeah. The West Rail, West Fleet. I think that's Metroliner related stuff. All right, so those are taken care of. San Jose. San Jose trucks. How many we got over here? And are we losing money or making money with them? San Jose got a whole lot of trucks in San Jose, and they're still not getting all the material moved. Let's see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of them. Let's cut that in half. Let's go ahead and get that gone for sale, and then we'll come up to the, where is it at? Oh man, it's way up here. Buy road vehicles, and we'll buy that. Buy four of them total. Maybe five, and then we'll set those. Where's San Jose? There it is. All right, so we'll get those guys out and rolling. Then we need to do this one up here, which is our oil factory. Oh man, the oil factory's gonna hate this. What's his production at anyways? 508, 506, fluctuating. Oh, he's gonna hate what I'm about to do to him. He is going to hate what I'm about to do to him. Oh man, all these trucks getting replaced over to the Pete's. Oh, we're gonna be putting some oil on him. Yep, that's what we're gonna do. Replace all those. This will be a nightmare, because all of them can drive faster on this road, because this one's kind of upgraded, I think, to a fast road. So not only are they moving faster, but they're also bringing in five more units per truck, six more units per truck. Oh, that's gonna push production up even more. Look, we're already sitting backed up over here. We got to start doing something about this line. Ooh, look at that, passenger line's up to 18 million. Oh, I saw 18 million just a second ago. That's a beautiful thing. All right, two more trucks to replace. And presto, everybody got a new truck. All right, anybody else need a truck? It seems like somebody else needs a truck. Oh, you know who? Dayton needs a truck. Dayton needs trucks. So let's replace all the Dayton trucks with Peterbilts. And we probably don't need, you know what we need to do in Dayton is sell trucks and buy new ones. Because we probably only need like two trucks here, to be honest. So yeah, let's go into Dayton. Let's sell their trucks and buy new ones. So sell everybody and then come here. Yep. And we'll buy two of those. I wish you wouldn't push down underneath my screen where I can't see you half the time. Here we go. All right, so those are running. And now we don't have split lines anymore. It's a beautiful thing. All right, so that is taken care of. That should be all of the upgrades that we need to do right now. All right, so just to recap, and just to make sure. Oh, the stone line is losing money? How is that possible? Oh, wait. There. The stone line can't be losing money. Did production slow down for some reason? Oh, you know what it is? I had time turned up a little while ago. I was about to say, how can this line be losing money? I had time turned up fast a little while ago so I could get the spacing on the passenger trains a little bit better. And when I did, I think that messed up the production cycle on this guy. That's all I can figure is it's messed it up to where, because that thing was, I mean, look, 616 units. How can this line be losing money with that kind of production going on? All right, so next thing we need to do, we've got to add another train onto here. The food line deal here has got to be taken care of. So we're gonna add another train in so that we can get more food coming back into town. So let's look at what we had going on there. Thousand Oaks food processor. We've got 2, 5, and 5 is what we've got going on that route. All right, so we'll copy that. Oh, that's not the train I want to put on. That's the train I want to put on. All right, so we're going to put... remember which train I'm using. All right, I'm using 2 of these. So, and the color we want to use on that, it's going to be that brown. 1, 2. Put them both on the same train. Thank you very much. And then we'll go 5 of these, 5 of those, all that good stuff. What do we get? Oh, stop the press. Don't be putting these on there. The EMD SD40-2. Oh, perfect timing too. Oh, thank you very much. We're gonna build a different train now. Why? Because this train is the cost of 1 of 2 of these for 1 of these. Oh yeah. All right, so let's do a comparison real quick. The EMD GP9 is 65 miles an hour, and the power on it is 17,000 horsepower. 288 kilonewtons on there, and our cost running it is $537,000 a year. Now, $537,000 a year, 45 year lifespan. This train is 3,000 horsepower, $926,000 a year, and a 50 year lifespan. The deal with this is, it's almost the same as 2 of these, but a little less money. So it's effectively, you know, we're not using every bit of 2 of these as horsepower to reach 65 miles an hour. So really 2 of these is a little bit overkill. And for the money we're spending on it, it would be better to go with just 1 of these. So 1 of these is gonna be what we buy for the train. So we'll buy that. And then we'll buy our gondolas, which I'm not gonna put any color on the gondolas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we need some boxcars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then when we'll set the line for this for Thousand Oaks food processor, and we'll send that on the way. Oh, that's nice. That's gonna be lovely having that baby. There she is, rolling out. Show me that train. Looking good. She'll come up to speed nicely. Oh, yeah. All right, where's our other food transport train at? This one we'll have to hold up and wait on it, probably. Well, actually, this one will come into the station and probably divert over to here. And then we'll wiggle to get out of here. At some point, I want to stop it so it doesn't get in the way of everything. This one's probably going to have to stop right here at this block. Beautiful how all this works. Where did that go? Oh, it went over to the... Okay, so that one's going to come to a stop there. And then this one's going to come out. And if we watch, it will wiggle. Oh, there we go. Ain't that awesome how it all works? Switches and signals, you're a beautiful thing. Alright, so let's see what kind of horsepower this guy's got. He's going 29 onto the bridge. 33. Oh yeah, we're climbing, we're growing. Speeding up a little bit. Alright, so he's 40 going over it. And then coming down the backside, he'll pick up a ton of speed. What I want to see is how fast this train runs in comparison. We can do a little comparison against the dual locomotives versus the single and see what kind of power that we have on the two of them. And we'll probably end up upgrading this train to this train very, very shortly. But that's going to get where we're having a backlog of food up here, as you can see. And we really needed to do something to clear that out. So that's going to help us out quite a bit. I'm going to keep this one in the station until this one is ready to return. So that thing's running 65, 66. Let this one get into the station and then start its return leg before I pull this one out of here. So, got it on stop. All right, so that one unloads, the dual unloads. All right, now they both can run. So let's watch how fast this one comes up out of here and goes up and over the bridge. Yeah, 33, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 41 at the apex of the bridge. 42 maybe, 41, 42. It looks like they're running about the exact same speed, which is good because that's what we want. We want this one to be able to pull comparable to this one because this one's running more locomotives on it than this one actually is. So that's a good thing. All right, here's the other little thing. We have got quite a bit of fuel loading up on the docks here. And since we just made that addition up there, this thing's gonna get quite full as well. And remember, I told you this was gonna get into a busy line. It's starting to get quite busy. So I think it's time that we go ahead and add two more trains onto this line as well. We add one into Oklahoma City and one into Irving, because if we look at the numbers, this guy is gonna take stuff and he's gonna leave quite a bit. I mean, he's leaving 241 fuel behind. That's just not going to cut it. So, time to get another train set up for that. Let's look at that train real quick and make sure that we know exactly what was set on it. Oh, somebody just upgraded production. Who was that that upgraded? Was it this? Oh, the stone quarry just upgraded to maximum production of 1,600 units. So, yeah. That line that was losing money a minute ago, it ain't losing money anymore. All right, so I'm looking for the, what am I looking at? I'm looking at the Thousand Oaks, Oakland. No, Thousand Oaks, Oklahoma City. All right, so that's two engines, four fuel, four box cars, four state cars. All right, so we are going to build a different train. We are going to buy a locomotive, and the color for that locomotive is going to be like a green. Let's go with a green for it. Yellow and green. That'll be interesting. That might be a little too much green. That might be a lot of green. Let's go with this green. Not so much green as just green, right? All right, so we buy one of those. And then we buy... All right, I'm going to make some changes here to this train. I'm going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these. I'm going to get 3 of these. And I'm going to get 5 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I believe that will fit. Gosh, I hope it will. All right, Thousand Oaks, Oklahoma City. Throw that on the line. Roll out. And that should fit on the platform because I took one boxcar away from it, and I added one state car and one oil car, but I also lost one locomotive. So that should all fit on the tracks and not have any issues. This little freight yard is about to get busy, 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 busy. I'm telling you. All right, so replacement. Let's get rid of those guys. All right, so this is the original train. Oh, we added his gray. Well, you're going to be green next time. All right, that train just barely fit. Hopefully, I didn't make this thing too long. Oh, I made the whole train green. Oops, I messed up. Oh, that's ugly. That's hideous. I almost want to return it to the depot and sell it. It's so ugly. It's terrible. It's terrible, I tell you. It might be changed to gray. I can deal with gray over green. I mean, that's green. That's a whole lot of green. Oh, that's putrid green. That's ugly. We may have to correct that with black or something. I don't know. All right, does it fit? Does it fit? It... Oh, it just fits. It just fits. Look at that. Just... barely fits on the platform. Oh yeah, we changed that off of green anyways, because that guy over there is a different color anyways. So what color do we want to make this? Black? Oh, that's not a bad look. Oh, I can handle that with a little Mr. Moose stuff on it and everything. Oh, I can handle that. Oh, that looks good. That'll work. Yellow and black. That works. That'll be our new color for the Oklahoma City line. Alright, so let's upgrade the Oklahoma City train to match the rest of that. So we're doing one of these. Oops. Make sure we get this right. Oh, who cares? One of these. 5 of those. Yeah, 3 of them's. Right, 3 of them's and 5 of that'ns. I went one too many, didn't I? Got ambitious. Nine's fine tries. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, all right. I'm just making sure I got that right. 25%, replace it. Bing, done. Just in time, replaced. All is good. Change the color, black. Because black looks good on that train. Bada bing, bada boom. All right, so that is that. That is Thousand Oaks. All right, let's look at Irving and see how much we're losing behind here. We're leaving food. Irving, Thousand Oaks, we're leaving. Well, come on, train, leave so I know how much you're leaving. Oh, autosave. Oh, you're sitting here waiting. Gotta have a clear line. This is a busy freight yard, is it not? I mean, was I kidding? We were going to get busy. Yeah, the cost of business has picked up quite a bit. All right, so that particular train is on its way, and it is leaving behind 106 construction materials, 22 fuel, and 40 food. Oh, no, that's San Jose. That's grain. Irving, 85 food it left behind. So, yeah, we definitely need another train for this line as well. So, back over here we go to purchase. And we'll buy another one. Let's get the color right on this one, okay? All right, so we're going to buy one of these. And the color on it's going to be like a gray, right? I think we went with that gray for that. All right, so we need one of these. There we go. And then we're going to get rid of the color on it. And we are going to go with, all right, five of these, three of those, and five of them theirs. One, two, three, four, five. All right. That's got it. Set that line for Irving, Thousand Oaks. Out to shoot, another train comes. I mean, it's getting busy up in here. Chooka, 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 chooka. Let's ride. It's getting to a point where it's fun to ride around here because there's so many moving pieces going. And it's just kind of cool to see how the little ballet works with everything, you know, racing one another to get to and from. As we pull up next to that train. So we'll get held here at the light, I'm sure. Yep, we'll have to stop here while he clears that block. And then we'll get the clearance to go. Another cargo line going up. Switch! 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 Oh yeah. Pulling right in. Right next to the Oklahoma City train. Somebody asked me to do more first person, so I'm going to try to do that. And flip, 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 flip. There we go. Now we can start to head out. So as soon as that one clears the block, we'll be on our way again. Because I do believe the train holding is the counterpart for this line. Maybe it's not. Nope. That is the other Oklahoma City train. So as soon as it clears, then we'll be clear to exit. And on we go. How awesome is all this? It's just cool to see it all work properly, you know? You got all the switches right. I mean, this is a busy little freight yard right now. And it will get busier. There's still more trains to add into it. So this is making the hill at 36, 38, 40. It's zooming, so. No longer does it have to stop for the passenger line. We do have to stop here, though, probably. Yeah. Yep, let that one clear out, and then we can hit it again. Very cool. That is very, very cool. So my question is, and I really would like to see what this train climbs the hill at, and I can't replace this one right this second because it's already in the station. So it's gonna have to run anyways. I wanna see what it climbs the hill at as well. Just to see if this was a valid swap over for both of these trains. Are you gonna swap over? Or are you gonna sit there and snooze? Come on. Oh, do I have you on? I don't have you on load, do I? Oh yeah, we're gonna have to take that off. Two trains, that's gotta come off. Make sure I don't have this one on that as well. Well, let's look at the Oklahoma City route. I do have it on load as well. That's gonna have to come off. I can't have them sitting there loading with two trains and going through a freight line, a freight yard. All right, so this guy, let's see how fast he goes up here. All right, we are 33. We were in the 40 range going underneath the bridge, so. If this one does more than like 50, I've made a mistake, but. Oh, this one's much faster. Yeah, this one's a lot faster than the other one was. Yeah, this one is, yeah, this one's definitely faster. Oh well. I'll go with what I got though. I'm pretty happy with it. Why are we sitting here? Why are we stopped? Do I not have signals on the other end of this? I do have signals on the other end. Why is he stopped? I'm confused. Where is he waiting on a free path? Oh no. Problem. Oh, thank goodness for the diamond switch. Oh, major problem. So this station isn't big enough. Did I really do that? There's a simple solution to it, but I mean, there's two solutions to it. One of them's kind of painful. Did I not make this a big enough station? Now I have to look. Upgrade station. This one's only 160, it's not 240. So the train doesn't fit. What happened was the train didn't fit and it was too long for the diamond junction as well. So when he switched around, the engine ends up here somewhere and it was coming back on the same line. So I've got to fix this station. As soon as this guy leaves, I've got to fix this station. Before this guy. Oh, this could be bad. This could be bad. Where's the other one at? All right, is that... Pause game. Let's look at where we're at here. Oh, this guy's just pulling in. Awesome. Awesome. Pull in and stop. This will work. I can do this. Pull in and... yep, stop. Alright, don't move. Alright, and where's this one at? Up here. Ooh, I can't believe I made that mistake. Well, sure I can. I make all kinds of mistakes. Alright, so... let's get this guy unloaded. See how much... wow, how long it is. So we have to have the station way up to here. Which is fine. We've got plenty of room to do this. So this train will flip. And any minute now. Come on. Flip. 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 Would you return back to the other freight yard? Thank you. Go, go, go. Go, 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 go. Go, go, go. Wow. This was totally not what I expected to do today for this episode, but that's what we're going to have to do. And pause the game. All right. So at this point, this station's got to be upgraded, and which means a whole lot of tracks got to be destroyed. Bulldoze. I mean, a lot of that track, all the way to there at least. That's got to go away. We might as well take that out as well. And... alright, so let's take this guy. Make sure we're not on the bulldozer. Upgrade it. And we'll make this 240 meters. Wow. If I go 320, does it go? Wow, it changes everything. Oh, it's going to be a nightmare to fix this. Hmm. I'm just curious. Let's see if we can push that train up the track. I'm pretty sure we can. We can push it up here. Come on, get on up the road. Bet you didn't know you could do that. But yes, you can push trains up the track just by destroying the track that's underneath them. Alright, so I'm just thinking in my head, might as well upgrade this to 3. I mean, we're never gonna use this though. See, I'm never going to go 320 with a train because the depot down there isn't big enough. And redoing that depot would be drastic. I mean, it would be a major... I mean, it's never going to be 240, more than 240 coming into here. Because that would mean a drastic overhaul of that freight station down there. And that's not going to happen. So no, I'm not gonna go any bigger than 240. Might put the side tracks on this though. If I do, does that mess up my connect? Nah. Don't need those. All right, so let's go ahead and apply our change here. And one of the reasons why I went ahead and got rid of all that track is the elevation change at the end of this ramp is pretty heavy. So we'll just go ahead and pull a nice long piece of track all the way up to there and we'll be done with this. So grab our track, grab our track, grab our track. We're low speed on this. I don't see a need to pull high speed. I don't want catenary either. You stinking game and you're... I'm gonna sneak it in on you there, Moose. Trust me, I'm gonna get it. Wow, we're gonna have to build up quite a bit. Too much slope. What are you talking about, too much slope? Oh, is it a bridge? What is that? Are you kidding me? And we just replaced this bridge, didn't we? Game, you do some silly, silly things sometimes. All right, so we just replaced this bridge. And we're gonna have to do it again. Sorry, good people of Irving, but I just keep destroying your bridge. I know y'all like that bridge, but... All right, so pull this. There we go, get that in place. Put some signals in and we should be good to go here. So a signal there and a signal there. All right, crisis averted. All right, so we're coming out of here. You need a signal here. And look, I know that there are implied signals in the game. Somebody wrote me the other day. I was like, yeah, I understand there are implied signals in the game. I just prefer to signal things up myself. I just like to do it. It's just one of those things I enjoy. Coming in this way, it is a freight. It is coming into here. I don't care about anything other than signaling this up. And I'll put a diamond in here. Go down the road when we have two of something coming into here. We'll have our intersection in there. And I need a signal here. There we go. And I think I need waypoints. There we go, and there we go, and that one there, and then, oh, let's double check our route here for Irving Thousand Oaks. There it is. All right, so we are coming in on this side. That is what we want. I don't even have to put it in here, but I'm going to just because I just want to know that it is signaled up properly. There, that is done. All right, so that's that. I need another signal anywhere. Got a signal's coming out. I need a hold signal on this side right there on that set of points. And I got signals there and there. We're good to go. And then those signals are a bit close, so we ought to delete those to open that block up. There we go. All right, that's good enough. That's good enough. All right, so we can come down here and I'll release this train. And then we'll start the whole system back up again. So grab that train there. No, not the... There we go. Unstop it. And then start playing. What do you mean, no path? Whoa, what do you... Oh, phew, I was about to say. What you talking about, no path? Hey, go back in there and get some stuff. Get back in there and get some stuff, dude. What do you mean, no path? How is there no path back in here? I'm confused now. I am lost. All right. We're going to have to double check this route. All right. Just run with nothing on. I don't care. Just get out of here and get on the road. Get on the road with your bad self. Oh, we got to get down here though. Pause game. I just realized something. Everything goes over this bridge. Or it's supposed to, anyways. I just remembered because I took out that road, all of my deliveries are going over this bridge as well, so. Man, I don't really need to be messing with all this stuff. Not what I planned on doing in this episode. I'm going to tell you that. I planned on working on San Jose, getting it tied in. But instead, I decided to make some upgrades. It's all for the best, though. In the end, it all works out for us, probably. Probably. Maybe. Hopefully. I sure hope so. Alright, so, let's get this. Ooh, hello. Somebody go where I want you to. There we go. Jump, 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 jump. There we go. There's our nice Metropolitan Bridge back. It needs to come up a little bit there. Looks fabulous. You want to put some guards on the sides of it? Sure, why not? Boom, that's back in place. Good pupil of Irving, I have put your bridge back into place. You should be happy. No letters of hate. No letters of hate. All right, cool. That's that. All right, there's one more upgrade that we should make with the Peterbilt. With the new train. And that is over here. I've been holding off on this line here doing any upgrades because I didn't want to spend the money on engines that I didn't need to. But these guys should be replaced now. They're doing their thing, but we can do much more with them. All right, so this station is 160. Why did I do such stations here? All right, so 120. They're running 120. Is this guy slowed down production? Seems like it. Oh, well, you're gonna start production back up. All right, so we're gonna upgrade these. Let's replace these. And the replacement of choice is this. And I do like the red for a fuel line. So we'll go ahead and add that. And then we'll turn off the red. And we'll let all the rest of it be in black. All right, so these do 18. So six of them is like a, what? 100 and... Oh, my brain is sore today. So five of those would be 90, 100. We'll go six trains. Is that right? It's 108. I'm just wondering if I can stick a seventh one on there. All right. It's tempting. No, I'm not going to. I'm going to leave them the way they are. 108's plenty. I just don't see needing any more than that. Alright, let these guys roll out. So we'll replace both of these trains. And, see how much of it fit on here. I could have gone one more. I could have gone one more for sure. But I think 108's fine, right? Is my math right on that? 108, yeah. They're not gonna move as many, but they'll move them faster, so that's fine. Oh, what'd we get this time? Oh yeah! Ooh, the Bombardier bi-level. The Chevrolet bus, the C-60, and the Concorde. I'm not really thrilled with the airplane thing. but the Bombardier bi-level. Oh yeah, I like that idea. So now you basically can double up the amount of people that are carried on a train, which will be unbelievably good. All right, so that train changes out. All right, so that is done on that end. Whew. How about that? Didn't get any construction done. Oh, these guys are backing up down here. This is not good, people. You know why this is? It's because we're not delivering enough fuel fast enough up here. That should change very soon, though, is with double trains up here running. We should be clearing everything out. And then the Peterbilts are just keeping the docks clean. I mean, as soon as it comes in, they're hauling it out. So there is no reason for that guy to slow down anymore. He should kick it into overdrive and really start production back up. And he is. Those numbers are climbing. Oh yeah. I'm going to push you up to 1600 as well, buddy. I'm going to get you up there. If I have to add more ships into the situation, I will. All right, so goody goody. I mean, we got some upgrades to do. I'll upgrade all the buses here, but let's look at the let's look at that passenger car that we just got. The Bombardier. So if we look at this guy, it's a bi-level. It holds top speeds 87 miles an hour. It holds 33 passengers on it, which we were holding 19 with our current cars that go 112. So we'll have to sacrifice a little bit of speed, but we can haul even more people. The question is, what do you throw on front of it to pull it with? And that's the question I'll have to resolve. We also got the EMD AEM7 that has just popped up as well. That we got in 1975. Somehow I missed that. There are 125 miles an hour for electrics. Operating cost is $1.95 million a year. And what is this one that we have? We got the Metroliner. I'm not really interested in it either. This guy, we're running $1.5 million a year, so, we'll see. I'll look at all the numbers, crunch them, see what I want to do as far as trains. I'm pretty happy with the train that we have. Let's look at our just numbers that we've got going on right now and slow this down because I don't want to be going that fast. Let's get the speed back down to normal. So, looking at our passenger line, it's now up to $21 million. Remember, the way we had everything configured before, and I had messed around with the idea of making this big long loop, but I wasn't sure whether one long loop would pay as much as running the short routes that we were running. And the short routes that we had running was making a total of about $14 million. We changed everything over to a long line and converted all the trains to bigger, faster trains. And because I'm delivering more people faster, I'm able to make now and get it up almost to $20 million. And at times it's up there and then it fluctuates back down, but it's running anywhere between those two. One of the issues I have is I have a gap right now. I have about a four train gap that I need to fill, because if you think about it, you should have a train for every stop you have on the line. And right now we're currently running 10 stops. So I should at least have 10 trains on the line. Every stop should have a train. If you were to freeze frame in a picture, you should have a train sitting at every stop. That's my theory anyway. So I should have at least 10 trains on this line. And right now I only have, I think, 7 or 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I need to add 2 more trains to this line at least to make sure everything is up and running properly so that we constantly have a train coming from here to here, here to here. There should always be a train in sequence running. So, and that's one of the things I worked on, was getting the train spacing right so I could do that, but I got sidetracked with upgrading all the other vehicles. We even still need to upgrade this line as far as the train on this line. Probably could use upgrading to the same diesel, but just to trim the fat a little bit, but we'll do all that down the line. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. As always, if you did, make sure you smack that like button for me and let your friends know about this video. It does help me out considerably, and I appreciate your support as always. If you're new to the channel, you consider subscribing. I do new videos each and every day. And as always, don't forget about the live streams. We try to do them every night at 6 o'clock, with the exception of Sundays. And I hope you will join us. That's it for today. I hope you guys had fun. I certainly did. I love this game. I could play it for hours and hours and hours and hours. And I could, even now, my brain is spinning, thinking about things I should tell you guys about. But we'll try to pick that up in the next episode. Until then, stay safe. Have yourself a wonderful day, and God bless you. Bye-bye.